Well, I have been known to be a little critical of the hypocrisy known as vegans. Okay, I think they're batshit stupid, but somewhere they lost their way and have a warped sense of what is actually best for the environment. This video I'm about to do is a vegan's reaction video. Now, as content goes, I really like this guy's work, artistically speaking, but his message at times is garbage. So let's get into this.
Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Please do not abuse, harass, or threaten anyone on this video that I'm about to take down. This means please do not go to their channel. But whatever you do, I'm not your papa.
And I'm an asshole.
He's an asshole.
Yo,
I'm an asshole.
Yo, yo.
I'm an asshole.
He's an
yo,
asshole.
Buddy,
Such an
yo,
asshole.
buddy, yo.
Hello everyone. In today's video we will expose that even in today's world, people suffer from such immense cultural indoctrination that they truly believe the enslavement and exploitation of animals is not only not evil, but also an act of love. I'm trying my best to keep this kind and rational, but I won't hold back when I get pissed.
Okay, and likewise. Let's see how you spin this so that it fits into the vegan narrative. And as a side note, this man said he is willing to debate me. And I am so glad to be potentially able to show the vegans why they bring so much harm to the environment. But I'm getting off topic. Please continue.
This obese woman we are about to see does not deserve harassment. She obviously really believes in what she says, but she has to be called out. This delusional bullshit has to stop.
I want to echo that same thing to this uninformed vegan that loves hypocrisy like a majority of vegans do.
Hey guys, some of you may not know me, so allow me to introduce myself. My name is Jess Peters, and I'm a dairy farmer from Pennsylvania. What? My family and I own Spruce Row Farm. That's it. And that's my family.
Yeah, huge surprise that at least two of you look highly obese.
This woman's size and weight has fuck all to do with the topic at hand, so stop with that straw man. But you're gonna bring it up again, ain't you?
Have you ever seen four people who look more like dairy farmers? Because I haven't, and I've met a ton of farmers. We milk Jersey cows.
Yes, but let's call it what it is. You enslave Jersey cows and steal milk from Jersey cows so you can then sell it and make money.
Look at those faces. Does it get any cuter than that? I don't think so.
It's disturbing to watch you calling your slaves cute. It almost seems like you disconnected yourself from reality and truly believe that what you do is in the cow's best interest. It is not. Please stop it.
It's really disheartening to see people shit all over someone's hard work, especially when they're a contributing member of society. But here, watch this, folks. Here's when the vegan, "My way is right," spin begins. And did I hear you correctly? Animals that have jobs are slaves?
My brother Cole and I are the fifth generation of our family to run this farm, so I guess you could say that farming's in our blood. Today I wanted to take a minute to talk to you about the animal rights extremist groups. Have you seen the ridiculous videos they put out there? They make such outrageous claims and false accusations about animal agriculture. I felt like someone needed to speak up.
These animal rights extremist groups. Tell me, what is extreme about not wanting to enslave another sentient being? What is extreme about not wanting to drink the secretion of an animal from another species? If anybody is extreme here, then it's the people who do enslave and exploit sentient beings, and the people who support it, aka ignorant morons who buy animal products. Just because everyone does it does not make something moral. We are a minority, that's why we are seen as extremists, but we have the moral high ground. You are not able to logically justify your actions. Stop calling us extremists when you're the one doing extreme things.
Yep, you said enslave. Hey, militant vegan types, you spin the narrative to justify your needs for the argument. It's not hard to see through the bullshit. And yes, I am morally on the high ground, but y'all say you are while trying to guilt and shame people that don't think like you.
Like, how can they be so successful and so wrong at the same time? So a few months ago, a friend sent me a video from one of these Facebook pages of a cow licking a cat. It was a lot like this one. Adorable, right? Cats love to be licked by cows. Every dairy farmer's seen this. Until I read the caption that said something along the lines of, "Even though this cow has never seen love in her life, she's still able to show compassion." How do you know that cow has never been shown love? Like, have you been with her every single day of her life? Because I have.
Spending every day of someone's life with someone does not mean that this someone enjoys it. It doesn't matter how much time you spend with someone, what matters is how you actually treat them. But let's keep going because you will talk about it right now.
I agree, and seemingly so far she seems to treat these animals well. She also seems to know what she's talking about.
Yeah, dairy farmers literally spend every single day with our cows. That's our job. So then they might say, well, that doesn't mean you treat them well, which is technically true. But let's look at this logically, shall we?
Yes, please glamorize the act of enslaving, serial raping, and exploiting sentient beings.
So exploiting and enslaving. So what about these animals?
Du hast mich. Du hast mich. Du hast mich. Du hast mich.
Which is okay for them because they're in an in-group. Remember, vegans hate that certain in-group animals argument. But wait, here's the backhand.
But pagan, cows are harmfully exploited.
But these animals were trained for this process, as are service animals that help the handicapped and disabled.
Yeah, dairy farms make their money by selling their cow's milk. A lot of farms will feed some of the milk to their babies and then sell the rest to a processing plant.
This sentence alone is enough to come to a conclusion. Dairy farms are evil. Oh, some dairy farms give some of the mother's milk to the babies. So even if some of the milk stolen from the enslaved mother cow is given to her baby, which is taken away from its mother right after birth, that still does not make it nice or kind or anything. It just makes it less evil. And what about other farms where the baby does not get a single drop of her own mother's milk? That someone sees this procedure as an act of love towards these animals is a clear sign of ignorance and cultural indoctrination.
You can't prove that that happens often enough to make that as your point, just as much as I can't prove that it doesn't. There are shitty farmers out there, absolutely. But you know you twisted her words there. By your use of her quote, you made it seem as if the calf gets very little. But here's some anecdotal evidence of hands-on working with these animals. Them calves ain't starving, and they get what they need. Now, a cow produces more than enough milk to feed the baby and give some more. In fact, to not milk the excess is quite painful to the cow, which is why we as a species, many, 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 many generations ago, started to drink it instead of letting it go to waste. But you want to see the cow in pain? Moral high ground? Check!
That'll make things like chocolate milk, or ice cream, or yogurt, or cheese. Guys, without milk, we wouldn't have nachos.
Without cow's milk, we wouldn't have nachos? Last time I checked, nachos didn't require the milk of a cow to taste good. I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm calling you a fucking liar on that one. I know you know damn well what she's talking about. But I will agree that there are alternatives. It's a matter of preference, and you fucking know it.
I can't live in a world without nachos.
Yes, I actually believe you.
Could you be any more condescending?
Just like people, cows do their best work when they're feeling their best. It's like I tell the kindergartners who come visit our farm every spring. You don't do your best on a test or run your fastest in gym if you're feeling sick or sad, right? Cows are the same way. They do their best work or make the most milk when they're feeling happy and healthy.
Have you ever asked yourself if the cows even want to do the work? Even if we assume that the cows give the most milk when they're the happiest, did they consent to being enslaved, exploited, artificially inseminated, and then robbed of their own milk? No, they did not. So looking at the assumption that cows want to be free from harm, free from exploitation, and free from enslavement, every single thing you do for them is straight up evil. And I think by the happiest you mean the happiest in the conditions they live in. If the life of a dairy cow can even be considered worth living.
So you hear that, pet owners, vegans, and non-vegans alike? Your pet is enslaved for your own entertainment needs. Now granted, we can only assume, but seemingly the animals are happy. Now their milk's stolen. See there? Now there you go again, thinking of your narrative with fuck all insight to the topic.
But you can't milk that cow just to give him some relief. I want to see that bovine suffer just so I feel better that you're not stealing an animal's waste product and selling it.
And considering that cows socialize, eat grass, chew cud, and wander around in a fenced area that for the most part protects them from most predator-like animals, well, if I was said cow getting my udders gently massaged to get milk out of my teats while I eat a meal, get my supplements, and my medical needs tended to, yeah, I think I could be happy, feel like I'm worth living.
And if we want to make more money, our cows need to make more milk. So why wouldn't we want to treat them well? Even though my brother is an actual rocket scientist, this isn't rocket science, guys. It's just good business. The better we treat our cows, the more milk they'll make, the more money we'll make. Win, win, win.
Well, it may be a win-win-win for you, but your basic concept of making money is based on the exploitation of other animals. I'm assuming you would not want to be enslaved and have an arm shoved up your vagina to impregnate you. I also think you would not want to be serial child-robbed and as soon as you lactate have painful machines hooked up your nipples to suck out the milk so someone else can sell it. So stop doing it to other sentient creatures.
You see what you did there? How very feminist and SJW of you. You took an assumption with no facts or evidence and said it was true and made a victim out of this animal. So let's break this down and show how he is wrong about this victim he created, shall we? First, some women get paid good money to have arms put into their vaginas. And that's not just porn and prostitutes. Surrogate mothers go through similar procedures. But also in this bizarre world, there are women that enjoy that in the privacy of their own homes. Or are you kink shaming now? And again, I realize you're trying to hammer home that having pets is enslavement, but stop it. Companionship is not enslavement. It's not always ideal, and no, you don't always like each other. But pets are not slaves, for fuck's sake, get that through your head. Now, exploitation of a waste product. If there is a market to exploit a waste product, then why not get some money out of it? I mean, really, if there was a worthwhile market to sell piss and make good money at it, you're damn right I would jump on that. In fact, I know my wife would be on board right along with me. Serial child robbing. Can I assume you can give citations? In fact, there is typically a whole bonding process as soon as the animal can be separated. More often than not, it stays with the herd. But for argument's sake, let's say that the cow is sold off and it's no different than when you sell puppies or kittens. Oh wait, that's enslavement all over again, right? And to your painful machines, you obviously don't have kids. And if you do, you have never seen a breast pump in action firsthand, have you? It can be painful, of course, if not done properly. But if it's uncomfortable, the cow will let you know. If you're around these animals for more than just a few days, you can pick up on this. Likewise with the breast pump. If it hurts, you can adjust. Well, that whole victim thing, I just made you look foolish, didn't I? Here's a hint. It's called common sense.
You suck at this. You really do. Be brilliant. 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 Be brilliant.
You lose.
Here's the thing about these extreme groups. Their big flaw. They think we're too dumb and too lazy to see past their basic video editing and fear-mongering to get to the truth. The real, honest truth.
I don't think we need activist videos to understand that exploiting and enslaving animals is wrong. All we need to do is put off the mask of ignorance. Look behind you, lady. These animals are standing next to each other. The environment seems loud and uncomfortable. They are forced to stand there and have machines hooked up their udders to suck out the milk. You would not want to be treated that way, and you cannot justify why it's okay to do it to them, but not to you.
You know, it's really not that loud, you big baby. I can hear the cows eating from their troughs clear as fucking day. And by the way, so you know, cows don't typically sit. So standing next to their family and eating their meal is cruel to these animals. So you think that these animals do not need a variety of food in their diets? And that they just need to eat grass? Oh wait, this is a vegan I'm responding to. They only hurt and exploit plants. You see, unlike people, they lack the ability to get all their dietary needs met on their own, so they depend upon farmers to keep them healthy, not unlike a child. That's also where they get their natural supplements to keep them producing milk. That way they don't have to keep the cow pregnant all year long, which is unhealthy for the cow. And the milk, by the way. I mean, could you imagine the overpopulation of cows we would have? Where would we put them all? Oh, whoops. Did I use plain common sense to debunk you again? I'm sorry. But it does take like 40 seconds to realize if what you just said makes sense to yourself after you say it. Come on, man, you're smarter than this.
But we don't think you're dumb. Farmers don't think you're too lazy. We think you're just like us, trying to create the healthiest, safest, happiest life you can for your families. That's all we're trying to do.
I don't want to go into detail why the milk of a cow is definitely not the healthiest thing to put into your body or your child's body or anyone's body, but that should be common sense. If you want to actually look it up, I recommend nutritionfacts.org. And no, your only interest is not to provide the healthiest products for other families, your goal is profit, which is completely fine with me, but don't exploit and torture others for your own benefit.
Holy butt fucking Muhammad, peace be upon him. We have been over this. Hey, Panda, want to buy some of my piss?
And here's the thing about video editing. I can do it too. I can make you feel things. Watch this. Thanks to email and texting. We're not dumb either, you know. We know what the problem is. You don't know us, and we don't know you. If you did, you'd ask us, right? I mean, I wouldn't ask a pastry chef to fix my car. So why would you ask an animal rights group about how your food is raised?
The sentence, "how my food is raised," in itself deploys an act of evilness, at least in your context. But other than that, you don't need to actually witness things to decide whether or not certain things are ethical. You don't have to ask dairy farmers if the practicing of enslaving and exploiting sentient beings is ethical. I don't have to go to Auschwitz or directly ask witnesses about whether or not the Jewish Holocaust was a tragedy. Sometimes all it needs is logic.
Okay. But how do you know the full context of said situation without fact-checking? By your logic, I can get and understand the vegan perspective by asking the local butcher what it's like to be a full-go, die-hard vegan. Because your logic, right?
You wouldn't. You'd ask us, the farmers who are out there every single day actually doing it. The people who work through blizzards and tornado warnings and freezing temperatures and 100% humidity to make sure their animals have exactly what they need. The farmers who stay up late with a sick calf to watch it take its last breath at 2 a.m. and pray that tomorrow will be a better day because you know you have to wake up and do it all over again. That's why God made farmers.
God does not exist, and of course I disagree. These animals do not rely on you to get what they need. They are living in these conditions and have to rely on humans because they are bred into existence and then enslaved inside a limited amount of space so you can exploit them and then steal their milk to make profit. All the hard work you're talking about may be hard work, but it is unnecessary and unethical. Looking at the fact that the milk consumption is dropping and the plant milk consumption is rising, please consider switching to a more sustainable, cruelty-free way of making money. The animals would fucking appreciate it.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Wait a minute. What did you just say?
And of course, I disagree. These animals do not rely on you to get what they need. They are living in these conditions and have to rely on humans.
So these animals don't need humans because they rely on humans. Interesting. Cow milk consumption is going down. Well, there are several reasons for this. More and more people lately are becoming lactose intolerant, at least in my home area. Two, the price of milk has increased dramatically. Less breeding of cows, so not much milk is produced. And finally, the vegan backwards thinking is gaining popularity because y'all are getting good at guilt-tripping and twisting your warped ideology to make it seem like it's morally the right choice.
Are you ready? It's about to get inspirational.
This is my fight song. Take back my life song. Prove I'm alright song.
Friends, it's time to know the truth about where your food comes from and the people who produce it.
I don't care where it comes from because I know for a fact that if said food contains animal products, exploitation and eventual murder were a necessity in the process of making it. Yes, all dairy cows end up at the same slaughterhouse when they are too old or just too sick to produce enough milk for the farmer to make a profit. To sum it up, I think there's not much left to say. Go vegan, follow me on Twitter, and subscribe to this channel. We are about to grow and we are about to kick fucking ass. Thank you so much for watching. Have a good one. Bye.
You don't care where your food comes from as long as I do know where mine comes from. Hypocrisy? Well, let me explain this. A lot of your plants need fertilizer to grow. Now, unless you like to trust unknown farmer to get all that off that involves chemicals that an average Joe Schmo won't even know about, then be my guest. But say you want chemical free. Well, then the farmer would have to get more natural fertilizer or animal shit. Wait, that's animal exploiting again. No problem. Go organic. Nothing wrong for paying sky-high prices for the perceived best, right? Sure, makes sense when you get what you paid for. But what are you really paying for? Well, without chemicals and fertilizer, the plants don't yield as much. Then the likelihood of sentient beings, or pests, to eat a good portion of the crop, so said farmer takes a bigger risk in losing his or her ass for that year. Now we can look at this a few ways from here. Maybe you're from a better to-do family and you can afford to go full organic. I have no issues with that, but I know I cannot afford to go all and only organic. Alright, next option is chem-free. Okay, so that's animal shit territory. But wait, didn't we watch a whole video about you saying it is wrong to exploit an animal's waste product for profit? Well, shit. The shit is out, unless you use human shit, which runs you into a whole host more of problems. So then let's look at the chemicals. Now this is a cheaper alternative yet. But wait, don't they use pesticides? Of course. How else do you kill off the less sentient beings by the masses? I mean, wait, pests are pests. Who cares about them? They're just bugs. But see, here was some vegan Gaines logic. He says that it's okay to kill pests because they are less sentient. But wait, the vegan argument is centered around not killing animals because they are less sentient. Go watch Ranting Monkey versus Vegan Gaines debate if you don't believe me. This is what he actually said. So which to you is morally the high road? You see, I don't have a lot of cash being on disability, having a 7-member family since before I became disabled to care for and all. And see, I can't use blind ignorance either. You see, I don't support halal food. If you did happen to care where your food comes from, you would happen to know this shit. Instead of blindly following along, I do like to do research on my food, be it plants or meats. And yes, there are some non-meat halal foods. So again, I do not support halal in the slightest bit. And so I don't just blindly follow and say, well, I don't care where my food comes from. Because I do. You see, you came off as ignorant and entitled by saying you don't care where your food comes from. So I say get informed and put some pork on your fork. Now you can tweet me when you want to do this debate, and please brush up on your vegan knowledge and on your opponent. Now to come full circle. As a content creator, I think you are great, artistically speaking. But whenever you spout your vegan bullshit, you come off as fucked in the head because you follow your vegan gods. And please know, I don't hate you. Hell, I could even see us becoming online friends, from my perspective at least. But I do think that you're misinformed and blindly following a planet-killing ideology.
If you like this video, please like, share, comment, and subscribe. See you next time.